you go through question and answer. I do believe that yesterday you have managed to submit your assignment, and you have good mood now. And if you have any question, it is time to raise them so that together we can address them with you. So without further ado, I will let you the floor. So if anyone has a question, he can raise his hand and can talk. Don't you have any questions? Show me some reaction if you don't have any question. Can you hear me out, by the way? Okay, all right. Okay, I assume that there is no question. So tell me how things are going with you. Did you manage to submit yesterday your assignment on time? How do you feel today regarding the remaining task for the assignment? How do you feel? How do you feel? What have you done? What is your progress? Maybe I will call people by their name. If you feel like to write in the chat, you can write in the chat. Mr. Collins, are you there?
Good morning, Mr. Rodo. I'm good. I'm here.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm here. I'm good.
Okay.
Doing great.
You feel like you do not have any problem. So that's good. Diana, are you there?
Hey.
Yeah.
I'm here.
Hello, Diana. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Okay. Yeah, I'm doing very well too. So, how about your assignment yesterday? Did you manage to submit on time?
Wait a minute.
Okay.
Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Now you can continue.
So I was asking you if you have submitted your assignment yesterday on time.
Yeah, I submitted my assignment.
Okay, you do not have any problem?
Yes, I don't have any problem.
Okay, all right. That's great.
Thank you.
You're welcome. What about Koga, Bernard?
Hello?
Yeah, Bernard.
I don't know if it's me. My other name is Kofi.
Yeah, it is you. Yeah, it is you. It is you. I was calling your name. So.
Okay. Thank you. I'm just trying to catch up on some few things that I missed, but I was able to submit and turn in my tax yesterday. So the only challenge is that it's not easy to be able to identify an AI generated document, especially when you are doing it manually. But I think that because if you take time, you might be able to spot one or two things from it. So I'm sure that the assessment from what we have submitted will also show that probably we are on the right path or we need to enhance on it. So At the moment, I haven't had any difficulty yet, just trying to catch up and see how the other tasks go as well. So yeah, I think it's okay for now.
Okay, all right. I really appreciate it. So it seems like you guys are pretty good with this week challenge. I'm very happy here. Okay, yeah, Godwin.
Good morning, bro.
Yeah, good morning, Godwin.
Oh, I'm doing well, and you?
Yeah, I'm doing very well. Thanks.
Actually, I was reading through tax 2, and then I kind of have a little bit of similarity between with tax 1. So can you just give us a clear distinction between the two tax? Is it that in tax 2, we are supposed to come up with our own kind of, let me quote and unquote, the marking scheme for identifying an AI, or are we supposed to use the same method for the tax 1, if like, which is involved in tax 1 for tax 2?
Okay, all right. For the task 1 and task 2, they are similar. The difference is you have in task 1 email communication, okay, you have email content, but in task 2 you have marketing content. Now for each of them you need to use the same procedure to identify if the email or the marketing content are generated by AI. Do you understand?
Okay, so I understand.
Okay, good.
So basically, tax 1 involves email, but tax 2 is not an email. It's more or less like a marketing, like a, let me put it this way, an essay that we are supposed to analyze.
Please, I can hear you very well. Can you?
Yeah, I was saying so. Yeah, can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm trying to say, so tax 1 in a way is more or less an email that we are supposed to analyze, while tax 2, let me use the word, an essay that we are supposed to analyze.
Yeah, and we have provided in the challenge document the email that you have a list of email. There's a link, when you click on that link, it will send you to that list in the folder where we have the list of emails, and you will choose among the list. I guess it is 5, if I'm not wrong, a given number, and you will analyze them to see if they are generated by AI. And we have provided to you a table that you can use to do that. When it comes to the task 2, you will do the same, and we have provided also a link to the marketing content that you will use. And among the lists we have provided, you will choose, I don't remember the number, but you will choose the number we ask you to choose, and you will analyze them to see if they are generated by AI or not. So that is it.
Okay. Yeah.
3 for the marketing content. 3, you will choose 3 of them, and you will analyze to see if they are generated by AI or not. Yeah. Thank you, Ikram, for the precision. Is there any question? Matilda, can we hear from you? Nobody is saying anything. It seems like they have understood very well the project challenge, and me, I'm very happy for that. Ikram, do you have anything to add?
I don't have anything to add for the time being.
Okay. Mr. Elvis, welcome. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, welcome. Okay, Jirma, you have raised your hands. We are listening to you.
Yeah, in my case, it's going well.
Mm-hmm.
I already submit my assignment yesterday, and the last one I will submit.
Okay, good. Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, on the form again. This got me. Hello.
Yeah, go ahead.
Initially, when we are submitting, we normally submit tax 2 to tax 4 for the final submission. But then
it is breaking a little bit.
Hello, can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Normally, when submitting, we normally use to submit tax 2 to 4, not for the final one. But then in the recent tax, technical challenge, it's written from tax 1 to 4. Is that a norm for this particular tax, or it was a typographical error? Because for all the other ones that we submitted, it was from tax 2 to 4.
Yeah, for this one, for the interim submission, you would submit tax 1 and 2. Okay. Yeah.
So, but the final submission, normally when we submit tax 1 for the interim, the final one, we normally submit the tax 2 to 4. But then for the final one for this, it's also stated we should submit tax 1 to 4. I'm just wondering whether the submission for this particular has been changed or...
Okay, if it is like that, it's not a problem for you because you have already done tax 1 and 2. Just you need to combine... to add the task 3 and 4 to your previous task and you submit them and you submit.
No, okay.
Yeah. Mr. Elvis, did you manage to submit yesterday your assignment?
Yes, I submitted yesterday.
Okay. Thank you. Do you have any problem? Any question to ask?
No, for now. For now, no question for now.
Ah, that's good. That's good. That's good. So, as you know, today's session is about question and answer. Do you have any other questions? If you have, you can raise them. So there's no presentation about something in particular. It's just about question and answer. Miss Nana, welcome. Can we hear from you? Who is there? Jonathan, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, all right. Can we hear from you?
Yeah, unfortunately, I didn't submit yesterday. I had something. So I was working on that in the meantime. So, yeah.
Thank you. Okay, you were busy doing something else.
Yeah. I was very busy yesterday.
Okay. Apart from that, do you have any question regarding the task 1 and task 2? Task 4, task 3, and task 4. Do you have any question regarding to them?
I think so far I have no question.
Okay, good. Yeah, someone else have joined and see. Nana Ama, can we hear from you? I think you have joined recently. Are you able to speak? If yes, speak. Otherwise, you can write in the chat. You submitted yesterday on time. Do you have any question for the next task? Okay, if there is no question, show me some reaction, okay? Show us some reaction. Okay, she has written in the chat, yes, I was able to submit task one. Why not about, why did you submit task two? What's happened? Yeah, we are still waiting for your answer. What's happening? You didn't submit task two. Do you have any blockers? Ah, okay. You are here to finish task two to four. Then I will submit. Okay, all right. So you, it's not that you have a particular problem, but it's time management. Okay, all right. That's good. Can, if there's no question,
can maybe we, let yeah. me add something. So like for okay. the interim submission we were expecting only task one, and then for the final we are expecting them to submit from task one to four. So like if there is anything they would like to add or they would like to edit or revise on the previously submitted interim submission, they can do, and then they can finally submit it on Saturday.
Yeah, good point for the clarification. So as everybody, okay, there is something in the chat. I just saw the remote worker challenge and I was not able to join the tutorial. Can I help with the children to help? Yeah, we will see. Ikram, do you know if you have already uploaded the tutorial of yesterday on YouTube?
Actually, I didn't check the career one, but the previous tutorial was already uploaded. We will check this one and we will reach out to Nana on Slack maybe.
Okay, good. Nana was, no, it's not Nana. Terefi is asking if we are going to submit us one twice.
Yeah, you are expected to submit task one for both the interim and the final submission. The final submission will include from task one to task four.
And as I was explaining earlier, this one is not a problem for you because it will just, you need just to combine the task one to what you have done later. Okay. Yeah, Bernard Kofi, you have the floor.
Okay, thank you. I don't know if I wasn't really clear about the tax on Notion. So I don't know if you or Margaret, anyone could maybe just provide clarity and then maybe try to take me through it. That would be great.
Can you repeat your question, please?
I'll say that I need a bit of clarity on the on the Notion tax regarding the Friday submission for the remote work tax, that is the career challenge. So I don't know if you or Margaret or anyone could just provide clarity on it, or anyone who has gone through it will provide a bit of clarity on it, that would be appreciated.
Okay, all right. Ekram or Kero, do you have an answer to that question?
Hi, guys. So I will contact Margaret and ask her to join if she's available. If she's not, I will make sure to, she will.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, but what? Who asked the question so that I can get it? Me?
Bernard? Okay. Thank you, Carol. Bernard Kofi. We will reach out
okay.
to you, okay, after giving the right information.
Yeah, I will also reach out to some of my colleagues. Collins is on, so I'll reach out if he could provide me with clarity as well in the meantime. Thank you.
You're welcome. Is there anyone who has a question?
Maybe another thing to add, like the career session, which was about remote work, is already uploaded, and I will share the link on Slack.
Okay, good.
Yeah, thanks. I'll check if the video of that session has been uploaded.
All the videos of all the sessions we have so far has been uploaded, so you can check that.
Okay, thank you.
That's a good news for you guys. For those who really want to catch up with the videos, yeah, they are now available for you. Do you have anyone, any particular thing to share with us? We never know until we ask. So, maybe if there is nothing to ask. As question regarding technical aspects, show some reaction and maybe you can, yeah, you can close the session because you guys do not have any questions. And yeah, and in case you have any question in later time, just contact us on Slack and we can provide you answer. Okay, Terefe. You have raised your hand, you are listening.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, everyone. My question is not directly related to this topic, but it's about the ranking of the weekly performance. So when I see my performance on week two, on some aspects, it's good. I mean, I performed very well. But when I see the final summary, it doesn't satisfy me. I don't know why. I couldn't understand what was my area of improvement. So if there is any key for answers, maybe for our assignments, I think it would be good to see our drawbacks and improve for the future. So it's the question as well as the suggestion for you regarding this area. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Jarefa, for raising that point. It's a good point you have raised. So for the final, you said for your task you have performed very well, and for the final mark you didn't perform very well. Did you receive any comments Did you receive any notification saying what you did wrong, maybe?
Yeah, I don't know. That's my question. You know, of course, I submitted all my assignments, the interim assignment as well as the final assignment. I didn't miss any of them, and I got excellent score on most of the assignments. But the final summary, I don't know why it was recorded like that. It doesn't satisfy me. And if you can, you know, how that summary was generated from those grades and scores. So if there is something that explain us to see our drawbacks and our way of improvements, I think that would be good to, you know, to do better for our future assignments. You know, that's why I'm raising this question. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, it is a little bit weird, and I will ask you to maybe share with us a screenshot, okay, through Slack, and we will see what's going on or not, and we can provide you some feedback. Apart from that, you have raised a point, and I think we're in the same alignment. Often, when we notice that there is something the trainee didn't meet the requirements or a given task, we always provide some feedback so that he can do better next time. So that's the way we do. And but if you notice that we do not have any feedback, yeah, then you can contact us and we provide it. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much. Actually, I have already put my comment on the comment section on the 10x page, so you can read the comment, and maybe next time I hope you will come back with me with your right approach regarding that issues. So okay. my question is particularly on the emails, list of emails. There are list of emails for all the trainees. So for each trainee there is a mark, you know, the weekly mark. So that's the point that I'm raising for now. So you can just see those list of emails with their marks on 10x, and then you can get the points. Thank you.
Yeah, okay. This is you are talking about the leaderboard. The leaderboard, okay?
Sure, sure.
Okay, good.
Yeah. So I'd like to make some clarification. So the leaderboard just works like it's not only to summarize the final score of the current week. It also includes the week one, your week one results. So like if you performed week two highly, and then if your week one result was a bit low, your final, like your leaderboard result might be affected by week one. So like it's not directly related to your week two score, but it might be affected by week one. So like for all of you, make sure to improve your results so that there won't be any low grades, or you can have a good and satisfying results. Rafa, did you hear what I said?
Yeah. I got your point. Actually, partially, I agree with what you raised already. But when I see the list of the emails, you know, it didn't affect, I mean, the previous week's performance, because the other trainees or colleagues, the similar performance like me, like on the previous week, all of us got the same result. But in the second week, there is differences. That's why I'm raising. Thank you.
Yeah, but okay. Always consider that the leaderboard, it's like a final summary for all For example, like for university students, there is something called the tempo, which includes all the results of their semesters for each year they attended during that university session. So like that, the leaderboard also includes your results for all the weeks, not only for the specific weeks that we are attending now.
Okay, guys, is any other question? Don't be shy. Say your question, okay? Consider that we are in a family here, and say your question. But if you do not have any question, just share some reaction and we can close this session. Margaret. Yeah, you have the floor.
Good afternoon, all. I heard there was a question for me, I think from Bernard.
Yeah, you can ask your question.
Yeah, thank you, Margaret. I just needed a bit of clarity on the tax on Notion. I don't know if you could help me properly understand it. Yeah, so that's what I just needed clarity on it. So basically, I don't know if I should be specific, basically on the format we had to use, and yeah.
Okay, sorry. So what exactly do you mean by format?
Okay, so it specifically stated we should use, is it the Kanban format? I don't know, I'm working on it. I don't know whether the system will give me that format, or that's what I needed clarity on.
Okay, so yeah, the Kanban format is basically just it's like three columns of in progress or to do, in progress, and already done. So if you go to Notion, and I think some YouTube tutorials or videos should help you figure this out, but it should. Notion can help you. It already has those features, so you just need to find them.
Okay, very well. I will check out the video though.
Okay, that's great. That's great. Thank you, Margaret, for providing us a nice answer for Bernard, Kofi. Is there other question? Okay. Ikram, anything to add? Anything to clarify?
No, I think we can wrap up the session. So have a good day for all of you.
Okay, good. Have a good day, guys. And for anything, be free to contact us. See you. Bye.